All right, I'm here with another one. I've got Sierra Nevada Beer for Drinking, BFD. It's a hoppy blonde ale. Just like to say, before we get started here, I don't have any rights to any of the music you may hear in the background. From anything from the 70s on up to today. So just keep that in mind. Again, Sierra Nevada, BFD, Beer for Drinking, Hoppy Blonde Ale. Something I really love on here on the can, it says family owned, operated, and argued over. That sounds like family, don't it? So did some research on this, and it said not for snifters. So I got all kinds of crazy stuff going on down here, but I'll just go with the typical beer mug, Missouri Tigers. Sierra Nevada Brewing in Chico, California, and Mills River, North Carolina. And as I said, I think once before, Mills River is, I believe, over just across the border from Asheville, North Carolina. What the heck I'm talking about? Wow, I can smell that from here. Super citrusy. Wow, that's just amazing. It smells really good. I've had this before. I'm gonna take a quick peek. Sorry about that. I remember trying this. But I thought it was like, wow, it's just, there's nothing special about this beer. But the aroma is phenomenal. Ingredients, as I did my research. Wow, look at that. Very small bubbles in the carbonation. Well, we got some decent head on that baby. It's like a lager poured right out of the tap there. So, all right, forget it. Untap's not pulling up, so who cares what I rated it before. Ingredients are yeast. The bittering hops are, I wrote some notes down here, the Simcoe hops, which are more the citrusy berry with a little bit of pine. And the finishing hops are Polaris and Comet. I tried to find in my handy dandy hops book on these hops. Could not find Comet in my book, so the hop is fairly new. Or my book is old, whatever. The finishing hops are supposed to be tasting like eucalyptus, peppermint, and citrus again. So both the bittering and the finishing hops have the citrus in it. And that's definitely apparent going by the aroma. The aroma, if I went on a scale of 1 to 10 on aroma, this is a 12. I mean, it's phenomenal, the aroma. Hoppy Blonde Ale. ABV 4.8%. IBU is 33, so I'm expecting a little bitterness on this one. Not a lot, but all right. So one more time to take a look before I start chugging this baby down. Hopefully it tastes as good as it smells. Okay. At first it did. Not saying it's bad. It's got a good bitterness. There's definitely a lot of citrus in this baby. A lot of citrus. That's overpowering. then you get some maltiness, and it's really bitter. Although the IBUs say 33, it's, I would guess without knowing that, that it was higher than that. But you know when you get those IPAs that are on the verge of getting old. I know some people say it doesn't matter, but it really does, at least to me. When I'm drinking an IPA and it's super malty, that means it's about time to dump that baby. That's just my experience. Let's see if I can find a born on date on this thing. I'm assuming that it says packaged. So it was packaged on May 8th, 2018 at 10:27 a.m. I'm assuming because it's not military time. So that's probably why it tastes like that. Currently we are on November 9th, I believe. So we're looking at 6 months. It's probably past its prime, that's for sure. But you know, it's still drinkable. It is, and if you like citrusy beers, this is the one you want. Again, Sierra Nevada, BFD, beer for drinking. Again, I do not own the rights to any songs playing in the background. I'm interested to see what I scored this, because even with this one being old, right now, as it stands, I would give it 3 3/4. On a hot summer day, I might go 4 4 1/4, but here we are in November. It's a little old. I'm going to stick with the 3 3/4. But you know, I would definitely buy this for 4th of July. Man, I don't know if you can hear that, but my kids are addicted to baseball. Here we are in November. And they're up there running around like crazoids. They've got some game they play in the hallway, catching the ball and diving and kids being kids. So, sounds like they're going to fall through the floor. Usually down here in the basement, but it's Friday night. I wanted to enjoy myself. So they are upstairs. Untapped has still not pulled up. I don't know what's going on. It's my internet or what, but kind of curious, buddy. Kind of curious what what I scored it. This is pretty good. I would definitely go and get it. Make sure it's fresh. I think a friend gave me this. You guys know Matt, if you watch. And you know Matt's motto, you go to the discount aisle. So that's probably where he got this. That's why it's from May 8th. So on the smell, it's super, super citrusy, super malty. Two row malts. And, acidulated. And Munich and Pilsner malts. So, obviously I pulled that from their website. I didn't pull that right out of my head. I'm not that smart. So, but I recommend it. Again, depending on the time of year. In the summertime, I would give this a 4 4 1/4. Being that it's November, I'm going with a 3 3/4. And plus, this is old. So even in November, if I had a fresh one, I would probably go with a 4. I recommend it. Go try it. drink it, enjoy it, and happy Friday. Everybody have a good weekend. Subscribe. Tell me what your comments are if you've had this before, and we'll talk at you later on.